So I am Florence Podevin, and so the girl who is here, and working at Tima Laboratory. And what I'm going to present you is the result of a collaboration with a laboratory Xlim in France and Sintra in Singapore that is working together with NTU. Sorry. And finally, we have a little bit of characterization at IMN, but not the ones that are presented here. And so the context is to deal with high data rates, but the issue with that, in order to get 10 to 100 gigabits per second, is that we need low-cost processes, low consumption, and from a passive point of view, 3D integration through substrate-integrated waveguide can be a nice solution. So there is an issue with substrate-integrated waveguide is that they are large because their width is about lambda over 2. And so what people want to do is that they want to reduce this length even if the waveguide is working at the same frequency. And so a way to do that is to introduce what we call slow wave effect. Because with slow wave effect, what we can see, I directly go to the results, is that the waveguide without the slow wave effect, that is the orange curve here, has a cutoff frequency that is higher than the one with slow wave effect. Okay, so this is very interesting because as we can see for a given frequency of operation, here we have a phase constant, beta, in radian per meter, that is higher with the slow wave effect than without the slow wave effect. And which means higher phase constant means lower lambda, and so shorter length, and also shorter widths, okay? So all the idea of the work is to know how to reach slow wave effect. So the purpose behind slow wave effect is a separation between electric and magnetic field. So when you have a propagation of electromagnetic waves, you have a coupling between electric and magnetic field. But if you store for a moment magnetic field or electric field without having the other, you store energy. If you store energy, you make the wave longer to propagate. So you have, the wave is going slower. And so because we store energy, so energy cannot propagate between during storage. And so, as we are slowing the phase velocity, we are slowing, we have what we call the slow wave effect. So how to have a magnetic field stored here, whereas here we don't have electric field? We need something that is conductive. And usually people, what they do, they put in a hair field waveguide, something filled with bland vias, okay? Because of the bland via, the electric field stop at the bland via, whereas the magnetic field can flow everywhere and around the bland vias. And so we have the slow wave effect. Typically, we have this curve here. The issue with bland vias is that they suffer from eddy currents, and so we have a little bit of losses. And so here we try to replace the bland vias by a forest of CNT, carbon nanotubes, because carbon nanotubes should be dense with high conductivity and above all only axial conductivity. They have no transversal conductivity. This is their main interest. So that even if their conductivity is not so high, because there is no transversal conductivity, there is no transversal loss. And so we are expecting very, very low losses in dB per millimeter, by using a CNT forest. So you see here in yellow, this is 200 micrometer, and in gray here, 400 micrometer. What is the interest is that the highest, the high of the CNT, so this high, the highest will be the beta at a given frequency. Here we had the results only with the height of 200 micrometer, which is the blue curve, whereas the orange curve is the one that is before depositing the CNT. So what we have as a result with a totally air-filled substrate integrated waveguide. And we see that thanks to the CNT, we could reach the slow wave effect. As you can see, we have 25% reduction in the cutoff frequency, which is equivalent to say that we have 25% in width for substrate integrated waveguide that would be the same as this one in terms of electrical response, and 25% reduction in length, meaning 25% by 25% reduction. The two combined will be a very interesting miniaturization in surface. Last conclusion, and that will lead to perspectives, is that here we finally measured high losses, meaning 1 dB per millimeter. This is too high at 28 gigahertz, and this can be due to the quality of manufacturing of the CNT. So, perspective, anyone that is able to make very nice CNTs, dense, well-sticked, is welcome.